contents of this box are two items, a Parker 51 Parker and a Parker pencil, mechanical pencil. They belonged to my great grandmother. She took remarkable care of these. They're in pristine condition. The box shows wear, as you would expect a box to do after so many decades. But what's inside the box is as good as the day they were new. It's perfect. The pen and pencil are still in their original cellophane. I think the color of these is it's kind of a teal blue, I think. Let me compare the color to the one I think is midnight blue. Get out of the cellophane. The camera may not show it, but there's a slight difference in the colors. This is midnight blue. This one is teal blue, I think. Let me hold a Parker 61 up next to it. Yeah, the camera's not showing the true color, I don't think, but at least not in my viewing screen. But this 61, yeah, the Parker 61 is a teal. Now, the thing about this pen that's been passed down to me that used to belong to my great-grandmother, she took remarkable care. Here's a photo of my great-grandmother when she was a child. Her mother passed away. She was less than 13 years old. And when her mother passed away, she had 7 siblings. And so her dad had to raise 8 kids. Ages 6 months to 13 on his own. I'd say he was a very remarkable man for doing that. So I guess he would be my great-great-grandfather. Now, inscribed on this pen is my great-grandmother's name. Prior to this video, I put a piece of cellophane tape over her last name. It's for obvious reasons. But the name, as you can see, says Nettie. which was a popular name back in the 1880s. Up until today, I was not even sure if this pen had ever been used. But I was looking at it under a magnifying glass earlier today, and I think I saw remnants of some ink. So in this video, we're going to ink this pen and write with it. I think that's what my great-grandmother would want. Back when this pen was new, it was considered a very expensive pen. I think this pen cost somewhere around $13. I mean, that was a lot of money for a pen, even today, in some people's opinions. The pencil, I'm almost certain that it's never been used. There's not a scratch on it. It's immaculate. And also inscribed on the pencil is Nettie. You see, Nettie, my great-grandmother, was a working-class lady. She worked very hard in a knitting factory or a stocking factory. Here's a photograph taken within the walls of the factory she worked at. You can see all of the sewing machines and the people that she worked with. If you look very closely to the far right to the edge of the picture, you can see that a face has been circled. That is my great-grandmother toiling away, as she did every day for I don't know how many years. I feel fortunate to have this photograph. And back to the pen. As I mentioned, I think that she may have used it, but if she did, it certainly was not used very much. So the first thing I'm going to do is put some water in the bladder. Now, I know some of you are cringing. Some of you pen collectors are cringing. But when it comes to things, you should enjoy things. If this pen were so valuable monetarily that it could provide for my family and I indefinitely because of its enormous value, I would not touch it. It would be in a safe. But that's not the case. This is a mass-produced pen from the 1940s. You can buy these pens on eBay all day long. Though you will pay $200 or $300 or more. But I really think my great grandmother would be tickled if she knew I was using her pen. She died a few months before I was born, so I never really knew her, and she never knew me. But wouldn't it be something if she knew that I had this pen and was about to use it? Now, maybe we'll see remnants of ink in the water. Maybe we won't. I think what I will do is lose the green felt and opt for a white tissue, so that we have a better chance of seeing any remnants of ink. Okay, the pen is in the water. I'm about to squeeze the bladder part. There it is. Green ink. Or at least it's green now. A beautiful shade of green. Now, I'm not an ink expert. I assume that they had green ink back then. But there's also the possibility that someone in my family inked this pen before I received it. That's about all I'm going to be able to get out. So, I'm not surprised that there was ink in it. As I stated earlier, I thought I saw remnants of ink on the pen. Later on, I will thoroughly clean this pen and put it away. But for this video, I'm just going to ink the pen. I was going to use this Parker Black ink called Quink, But now that I see that the ink in the pen, or what's left of the ink, is green, I'm gonna choose a green ink from my collection. So stand by for just a moment as I dig up some green ink. Okay, I have here a bottle of diamine jade green ink. And I have a bottle of Noodler's green. I'm not sure which one to use. This looks a lot like the color. Let's check out the jade green. I think I'm going to go with a Noodler's green. And so as I mentioned, I'll dip this end of the pen into the bottle. I shall depress this to squeeze the bladder, which expels the air. I'll release this, and ink will be drawn up into the bladder. I don't know if you'll be able to hear the air bubbles. Maybe, maybe not. Let's give it a shot. Now, some of you are thinking that I just contaminated this bottle of Noodler's Green with some old foreign ink that I know nothing about. It's okay. It's not a big deal. It's just a bottle of ink. I'm not concerned about it. And neither should you be. Now, before I go any further, I'm going to move slowly so as not to make a mistake. And I'm going to put this cap back on the bottle of ink. I cannot stress how important it is to put the cap on the bottle of ink when you're finished inking the pen. If you tip over a bottle of fountain pen ink, it is without a doubt one of the great disasters of mankind. If you don't believe me, ask my wife. Okay. The pen is inked. It's been wiped off. Let's put the barrel back on. Let's put the cap on for now. Let's move some items out of the way. And I can't believe that the notebook that I had off to the side, I've mistakenly covered it with Parker 51s. So I'm going to have to move all of these items off of here. Starting with the pens. Now, the Noodler's Green ink. A key. A magnifying glass. And a Zippo. That I do lighter tricks with. Now, what shall we write? First, let me zoom in. And now that I've zoomed in, I have to refocus. Because I use manual focus. When I use autofocus, the microphones pick up the noise of the autofocus as it tries to stay focused. My great-grandmother, she, as I mentioned, she was a working-class lady, meaning that she worked in a factory and she worked hard. She had one daughter, my grandmother. Here's a photograph of my great-grandmother, Nettie. Looks like she's at a wedding of somebody. I bet she never thought when she was at that wedding that many decades later a family member would be about to write with her beloved Parker 51 fountain pen that she took very good care of. And I think the pen was a gift, is what I suspect, from a relative of mine that worked at Parker Pen. Let's just write something. Let's write her name. Did I spell it right? Let me look on the pen. N-E-T-T-I-E. As I suspected, it wrote very smoothly. So what are some other names that were popular back in the 1880s? Lucky for you, I have a list. I'm going to jot down some of those names. So Nettie and Minnie. Oop, there's an E that goes there. And Bertha. Oh, this pen is so smooth. Just the right amount of feedback. It glides on this Claire Fontaine paper beautifully. Here's another name from back then. Clara. Let me move to the next page. And here's one, Bessie. I had a cousin named Bessie. Moving on, how about Ethel? And Martha. Gosh, I love this pen. I might want to write with this on a daily basis for a while. I think I will. Mabel. And Helen. Here's one, Maud. And Gertrude. I'm gonna turn the gain on the microphone up a little bit so maybe you can hear the pen as it glides across the paper. What was I about to write, Gertrude? Gertrude. I'm going to turn the mic up just a little bit more. How about Edith? Look, I crossed the D. Let me fix the cap. That's my excuse. I had the cap rotated wrong. Let's write Edith again. And this time, get it right. And I still just about blew it. Here's one. Myrtle. Myrtle. Agnes. Agnes. Blanche. Daisy. Ruth. And if you just heard my stomach, I apologize. I'm starting to get hungry. Irene. Harriet. Mildred. Beulah. And I think that's all the names all right for now. I have a list of the 100 most popular names in the 1880s for females and for males. I thought about doing a video where I read all 200 names. Let me know in the comments if you think that would make a good video. The pen is starting to run dry. Most likely a case of a nib, not having sufficient time to soak up ink. It still seems dry. Running out. I guess there could be something wrong with the pen. After all, it's been sitting in a box for a very long time. It has a breather tube inside of it. And if the breather tube gets clogged up, it can affect the way the pen writes. So, maybe it's clogged up. Well, this video is going on an hour long, so I'll see what I can do about making the pen write better. But let me leave you with this photograph of the lady that owned this pen. The lady that is departed from this earth many, many, many decades ago. And this last photograph, it almost looks like she's looking at me, telling me to take care of her pen, that she has to leave now, and to take care of the pen. Now, obviously, she's not thinking that at all, but I kind of like to think that maybe she is. So, I hope you enjoyed this. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.